One of the leaders present at this summit in Brussels was the Swedish Prime Minister, Stefan Lofven. I spoke with him earlier today and asked him how the negotiations were going.
We hope they can reach an agreement, and I guess it's the same issue as everybody talks about, the balance between, on one hand, taking note that there is huge problems in Greece, people are suffering, hard times. On the other hand, there is a deal made, and if that is supposed to be changed, all the parties has to agree upon these changes. And also Greece need to make some structural reforms within the country for the future.
If I were to put it to you, though, that if Greece were given leniency on its bailouts, the ability to scrap that bailout altogether in terms of the terms and conditions and to change them for something else, doesn't that create a dangerous precedent for other countries like Spain that are facing their own radical movements inside during a crucial election year?
No, exactly. That's the point. That's the tricky balance. And that is why, of course, the other countries say that, well, we have a deal. Let's fulfill that deal. So this is totally up to these countries that are involved. It's mainly the loaners to Greece are mainly Euro countries. So we are not part of that discussion. We see the tricky balance, and we will see what will happen on Monday.
Let me ask you about Ukraine. This ceasefire is already looking as though it may be dangerously frayed. We have reports of Ukrainian soldiers having been killed just hours after the ceasefire supposedly negotiated. If you had to put the chances of this ceasefire living up to expectations, where would you put them?
I won't say a percentage of chance or so. It's we said yesterday we agreed upon, we have an agreement now. It's a fragile agreement, but it does give us a glimpse of hope, and that is very important. But there's so much to do to actually have a real ceasefire. And as you say, we can see the violence is going on right now, although there should be a decrease of violence to make sure that the ceasefire is really functioning on Sunday. So there's many obstacles left to pass, but we have this agreement now, and we as European Union and as member state will also be involved and engaged in making sure that we can implement this agreement fully. Ukrainian people needs peace now. They need stop for the suffering, stop for the killing. And President Poroshenko told us yesterday that he went to one of the cities and saw the effects of all these shootings, and he saw one little boy, a three-year-old boy, without hands. And what he saw in this boy's eyes was just the question, why? What happened and why? And President Poroshenko is making a tremendous effort. He wants to end this violence, end the killing. And I would also give high credit to President Hollande and Chancellor Merkel for what they did, the effort. And now it's up to us all to make sure that this agreement is fulfilled.
That was the Swedish Prime Minister talking to me from Brussels on the issue of Greece and Ukraine.